Final two races then at Sha Tin. A pair of class twos with plenty of class on offer. This one over the 1600 metres. The field headed by Savvy Nine won the January Cup at Happy Valley back in January at Group 3 level, of course. Tourbillon Diamond out of the 4-year-old series finished 7th in the Derby Circuit 3. Odds on, beaten favourite last time out, had won the start before here over the mile. Charity Go, runner-up to Butterfield last time out. Big Wood, we haven't seen him since June 2019. Maximus out of the Derby as well, where he finished in 11th place. Savaquin's place behind Charity Fun last time out through Arthur's Kingdom, Super Football and Celestial Power. We should roll forward from his inside gate, Barrier 2. He was a long way behind Butterfield last time. A whole host of these, Tom, have been up at Chung Fra, including Big Wood, who's been off the track for some time. Great to have him back, mate.
Certainly is. He's had a couple of trials are coming into this and the speed here. Well, not again, no clear obvious leader, so it might be left to Solar YY, who's been handy in the past. But I thought maybe Celestial Power might be able to lead as well out of gate number two. Led last time out, that was over 1,800 metres. Maximus won't be far away. He's drawn in gate number six and circuit three, coming back from a lameness issue, drawn gate number seven. Now, a lot of horses get back here. Savvy Nine is on that three wide line. Arthur's Kingdom's very wide. Charity Go, Savaquin, Tourbillon Diamond, Super Football, all likely to be in the rear half.
Yeah, two horses in this race. Charity Go in front there, leading out Tourbillon Diamond. Both horses having just a nice quiet jump out down the back straight here and just maintaining fitness. So just a maintenance gallop for the two of them. And you can see held together nicely. Savaquin, a quiet workout for him as well. But he's a very fit horse. That's him in the blue saddlecloth. We've seen plenty of him this season. And he moves nicely as well, does Savaquin. He's had 10 starts already this season. Very fit horse. And Super Football, he moves nicely. Just, again, a slow maintenance gallop for him. He's a two-time winner this season already. And he moves nicely enough as well. So he's just drawn a bit wide, but he'll get back anyway.
All right, we can have a look at Super Football in this first race. We take a check on, in actual fact. Butterfield wins the race. Charity Go runs second. Maximus then went on to run in the Derby. But how do you line all these up, Tom?
Well, Charity Go, he's been in good form. He's been consistent. He was at the rear. He's a little bit wide down the side. You can see him with the shadow roll right out wide on the track there, still making inroads at the end. He's had a trial since. There was nothing wrong with that. I'd be inclined to have a little look at Maximus as well. He had excuses last time out, pulled up with the mucus out of the Derby. He missed the start as well in a run recently. So then race wide. So he's had the odd excuse recently, Paul.
Yeah, and Super Football, he came out of it winning two in a row and he didn't run too badly in that race either.
OK, what about Savaquin then? Paul, now his winning has been done at Happy Valley. We can have a look at him here last time out over the 1,800 metres, finishing second behind Charity Fun.
Yeah, it definitely is a better record. It has been at Happy Valley. He has been placed at Sha Tin before here with Joe Mirabord, and he's been a very consistent horse throughout his career, especially this season as well. So another good run from him here.
I thought his run at Sha Tin 2 back was very good because he missed the start. He just did something wrong with the gates and missed it by probably four, five, six lengths, but made up a lot of ground in the straight. So I wouldn't be leaving him out either.
OK, more Derby form on offer here with Tourbillon Diamond, who's first up since that run behind Sky Darcy. Circuit 3, the other one engaged in this trial, Tom.
Yeah, I liked this trial here from Tourbillon Diamond. Settled at the rear. I thought he got to the line quite nicely down the middle of the track without too much pressure. And he did travel a little wide in that trial there as well. But there was nothing wrong with his run in the Derby as well, Paul. He was still making ground at the end, I thought.
Yeah, he just got too far back and the race wasn't run to suit. So, yeah, he looks the main one of the main chances, does Tourbillon Diamond.
OK, and the final we're going to have a look at is Big Wood. He's had two trials to warm up for this, Paul. How do you think he's looked?
Yeah, the trials have been OK. It'd be a huge effort to win fresh up after a couple of years, though. But, look, the horse has gone nicely in the trial and they've obviously persevered with him. He's a seven-year-old now.
Yeah, so a seven-year-old that's only had 10 starts and nine of them here in Hong Kong. And, look, he's had a long time off with a couple of left front tendon injuries, a right front bone stress injury, which has kept him away. He's up 27 pounds on his last weight. I'm actually going to sneak him in. I know it's a stiff ask, though, Andrew. We're first up after 690 days.
It's a long time, but we wish him well on his return. Tourbillon Diamond, Paul Favourite, in a very open-looking race.
Yeah, look, I'm going to make my each-way play in this. Currently at 12 is Super Football. He's only carrying 113 pounds, I think, which is really good for him. He'll get back, he'll be running on strongly, and he's already a two-time winner this season. Tourbillon Diamond on the back of that trial looks very hard to beat. Maximus has had excuses from Barrier 6. He's another possible leader in the race as well. And then Circuit 3, he's another one, gets back, runs on strongly. So 13, 2, 10 and 4.
2.11, 7 and 8. I think Tourbillon Diamond will be the toughest to beat in this race from what he's come through and done through the four-year-old series. Takes a little bit of a drop in grade here to class two, and I think he'll be tough to beat. Savaquin hard to leave out, Charity Go, and Bigwood makes it in as well. So 2.11, 7 and 8.
Yeah, I've included Bigwood. Had a lot of ability last time we saw him. See if he's held on to that. But 11-2, my cue there in race number 9.